Hello friends, I am Harsh Shah and I will like to help you in starting the Raspberry Pi. This is my first video, so let us start. What we will do first is just take the Raspberry Pi and connect it to HDMI and power cord. You will notice that it does not start. That's because it does not have any operating system. So just take any SD card you want, but if it is SD card with a better speed, then it will help you a lot. Just take it and make sure that it is greater than 8 GB so that you can install many programs and other things on your Raspberry Pi. Just insert it into the slot provided in your computer and visit the Internet Explorer and visit the official site for downloading the OS operating system. I will be showing you how to download the Raspbian OS. It is an official operating system of the Raspberry Pi. Just type this and you will get this site, first site, the raspberrypi.org. This is the official site. Just click on it. It will open up the site. Click on downloads. In that, if you are having a noobs SD card, then you can install it using the noobs, but for a normal SD card, just take Raspbian. Now in this you have two options, for with desktop and other recommended softwares, and here this is only with desktop, so I have downloaded this. You can download it with both by using torrent and zip, so I have already downloaded it. You can download any of the both. Just download it and also download this software called Balena Etcher. It helps you to flash your OS images onto your SD card. So just open Balena Etcher. This is an official site. All the links are mentioned in the description below. Just click on that. It will automatically detect your version, Windows version, or if you are a Mac user, then Mac version. Just select it and click on download. You will get downloaded. I have already downloaded this too. So just install that software. And that's all. Now when you are downloaded, just open Balena Etcher. When the Balena Etcher is opened, you will notice that it has already selected your SD card. Just select the image which you want to flash. Click on select image. Click on Raspbian stretch. It will get selected and click on open. Make sure that the SD card which you are using is already formatted. And then click on flash. I have already flashed it onto another SD card, so I won't be able to show. It takes about 17 to 20 minutes based upon the speed of your SD card. I have already flashed it. I won't be showing, otherwise the video will come too long. So now follow the steps. This is an older version of Raspberry Pi I am using. As you can see, it has got two USB pins, one Ethernet, one HDMI, one place for inserting your USB type A so as to give it power, one slot for inserting your SD card. If you are using a Raspberry Pi which has a model number greater than 3, then you might be having a slot for micro SD card, but it will be the same. This one is for audio output, this one is for video output, and we have got this 40 GPIO pins which help you in day-to-day robotics projects. Just take up this SD card on which we had flashed the Raspbian OS in the earlier video. Just take it and insert it into the slot which has been provided to you. Here it goes. It has been now connected. Take your Raspberry Pi close to the monitor and connect it using your HDMI cable. See, like this. You just connect it into the slot. Connected.
Now take your power cord and connect it. It can be any adapter, no need to worry. Just connect it into the slot provided. As you can see, it will light up, and so will the your monitor. Just wait patiently, it takes time for it to load. You just have to sit back and relax. As you can see, the Raspberry Pi logo has appeared over here in the corner. First the mouse will appear, followed by the desktop. As you can see, the desktop has started appearing. A dialog box appears in the center saying welcome to Raspberry Pi. Welcome to the Raspberry Pi desktop. Before you start using it, there are a few things to set up. So you have to follow the instructions to set it up. I will show you how to set it up. I have got this wireless thing to attach to the Raspberry Pi so that I can access the mouse. Just take your Raspberry Pi and connect it onto one of the slots provided. As you can see, it is connected. The mouse started working. Click on next. It will ask you to set the country, language and time zone so that we can use it easily. I am an Indian, so I will select the country as India. India. The language will be English, and the time zone is set default as Kolkata. Click on next. It takes some time for setting the location, so you have to wait. Now it is done. It is telling you to set a new password. The default user account is Pi and the password for it is Raspberry, all in small letters, RASPBERRY. I won't be changing it now, you can change it later. Click on next. Now to update the software, it takes more than 30 to 40 minutes, so I will be just skipping it. And you require internet connection for it. If you are using the same version as I am using, then you won't be able to upgrade because you are not connected to the internet, as the older version does not have the facility to connect wirelessly. You have to connect using Ethernet, which I will tell you in the next video. Just skip it for now, and it will say it is complete, so you need to reboot. Click on reboot. The Raspberry Pi restarts. Appear followed by the status bar and then the entire desktop. In such types of speed, you might be feeling that it's taking too long for it to start, but you have to accept that it is a fast thing for such a small device. And here it comes, the Raspberry Pi desktop. Set up and ready to use. Here we have all our pre-installed programs. In programming, we have many languages such as BlueJ, Python, Scratch, and many more. In education, they have provided something as SmartSim. We have got Office, just like our Microsoft Office. Then the internet consisting of the Chromium web browser, the mail and VNC viewer. Then we have got VNC Media Player, then our image viewer, then Minecraft comes pre-installed. Accessories are there like calculator, and we have been provided with help. And then there are some preferences to set up our desktop. Then we have got the run command, and finally to shut down your Raspberry Pi. We have this Internet Explorer here, the Chromium web browser, you can say it. Then this is the file explorer, and we have got the terminal window. This is just like CMD through which you can operate your entire Raspberry Pi. We have the recycle bin here and we have got Bluetooth. If you are using my old version, then it does not have pre-installed Bluetooth, so you will need an adapter. Here this is for Wi-Fi. If you are using the latest version, then just select the wireless thing of which password you know, and then you will connect to your Wi-Fi wirelessly. This is for controlling your sound. It does not have inbuilt speakers. You have to connect external speakers using the audio output which I showed you in the video. This is for ejecting any devices which you have connected in the USB slots, and this is the time. So that's it for the video. Press on subscribe and like button to like my video, and stay connected with me for any queries. Just mention them in the comment section below. I will always try to solve them. Thank you.